Hello everyone. Today we'll discuss the digestive system in Pila globosa. The basic plan of the digestive system in Pila is like other animals. It starts from mouth and ends at the anus. Starting from the mouth, then comes the buccal cavity, which is enclosed in a buccal mass, and then it is followed by the esophagus. The esophagus having the esophageal pouches. Then this esophagus that leads into the stomach, and this stomach it leads into the tubular structure that we called it as a intestine. And after intestine, it leads to the what? The portion that we called it as a rectum. And finally, this rectum opens outside by the opening that we called it as a anus. So, the basic plan of this digestive system in Pila, that it comprises of the three parts. What are these? These are the foregut, midgut and hindgut. The digestive system in this Pila is a long curved tube that extends from mouth up to the anus, and it having the three different parts. What are these? One is foregut, another one is midgut, and the third one is hindgut. The first one is a foregut. The foregut is ectodermal in origin, and it consists of mouth, buccal mass, and the esophagus. Means starting from the mouth, this buccal mass having the buccal cavity and the esophagus. This comprises of the what? The foregut. And the mouth is a median vertical slit situated at the anterior end of the snout that leads into a thick-walled buccal mass. The buccal mass, it includes, this is the mouth, and the after that this is a buccal mass. That buccal mass, it includes a cavity, and that cavity we called it as a buccal cavity, which contains the two jaws and the radula. This is the radula, and the, again it possesses the word that is a two jaws. Then both the jaws are connected together by the thin cuticular membrane. The jaws bears numerous small and two or three large teeth. These are the jaws structure, and these are the what, the cutting edges of the jaws. Then these jaws bear the numerous small and two or three large teeth. The jaw divides the buccal cavity into an anterior smaller cavity called as a vestibule and the posterior larger buccal cavity. Means it divides the cavity into the two. One is a what? That is a the vestibule, that is an anterior smaller cavity, and the posterior larger cavity that we called it as a buccal cavity. This is the what? The buccal cavity. Then the present on the floor of the buccal cavity is a rounded elevation, and that rounded elevation is called as a what? Odontophore, or it is also called as a tongue mass. So if you, this is the what? The how the buccal mass is there. It divides the buccal cavity into the what? The subradular cavity and the posterior, that is a radular sac. The odontophore is made up of muscles with a cartilaginous support. The anterior end of odontophore is round and is known as a what? The subradular organ. And this is the radula structure having the what? The chitinous teeth. And the beneath the subradular organ is a small sac-like part, and that is called as a what? The sublingual cavity. This is a what? The sublingual cavity. And jaw work against subradular organ to cut the food into the what? smaller particles or into the smaller bits. So along the upper surface of the odontophore, there is a chitinous ribbon-shaped organ, and that is called as a what? The radula. Means here the what that is on the odontophore, there is a what? This is a radular structure or the radula. And this radula having the what? It is a ribbon-shaped structure. Posteriorly, it is enclosed in a sac, and that is called as a what? Radular sac that extend below the buccal mass. The radula bears numerous backwardly directed hornetae. This is a radula having the flap on both the side, and this is a ribbon-like structure, each having the what? That is a transverse rows of 7 teeth. The radula bears numerous backwardly directed horny teeth arranged in a transverse rows. Means in transverse rows, horny teeth are present on the radula. In pila, each transverse row possesses how many teeth? 7 teeth. At the center, it is a what? Median rachidian teeth. On its either side, the what? The lateral marginal teeth, or the lateral teeth and two marginal teeth, and this is the what? The inner marginal, and next to that outer marginal. Means that the center median rachidial, then on both the side of this median there is a lateral marginal, then the what? That is the inner marginal and the outer marginal, and thus it gives the formula 2H2 1H2 1H2 2. So this is the what? The formula of the what? That is a teeth. Then the teeth of the radula are secreted by the special cells, and that cells are called as a what? The odontoblast cells, which are arranged in transverse rows at the posterior end of the radular sac. The teeth which are present in the what? That is a radula, keep on moving forward, replacing the broken and worn out teeth of the anterior part. Thus, anterior most teeth are oldest and most worn out. The radula grows at the rate of 1 to 5 rows of teeth daily. The teeth are pointed with the sharp edges and are used like a saw for cutting the food material. The radula is moved forward and backward, up and down with the help of the protractor and retractor muscles, and act as a rasping organ. A subradular membrane is present below the radula. Then the pair of salivary glands are present on the side of the buccal mass, and their ducts open into the buccal cavity that releases its secretion into the buccal cavity. The secretions of the salivary gland contain the mucus and an enzyme which digests the starch. The mucus lubricates the radula and helps in the transportation of the food. Dorsally, the buccal mass leads into a long narrow esophagus. Just below the salivary gland, near the origin of esophagus, are a pair of round esophageal pouches. And they are prolongations of the esophagus and probably secretes the what? The digestive enzymes. Digestion starts in the esophageal pouches, and they also serve as a site for the temporary storage of the food material. A pair of buccal glands are present in the roof of buccal cavity, little in front of its junction with the esophagus, and they are probably the accessory digestive glands. After the foregut, next part is what? The midgut. The midgut means just after the esophagus. The midgut is an endodermal in origin, and it consists of the two things. One is a stomach, and the what? That is another one is the intestine. Esophagus opens into the stomach, which lies on the left side of the visceral mass, just below the pericardium. And it is red in color. The stomach consists of two parts, the sacular or sac-like cardiac chamber on the tubular portion, this is a cardiac chamber, or this is a saccular portion, that is a cardiac chamber. And after that, this is a, what, the tubular part. And this tubular part is the tubular pyloric chamber. Means the stomach can be divided into two parts. The saccular part, a cardiac chamber, and this is a pyloric chamber. And after that, the intestine will start. So, this is the midgut. The foregut, it comprises starting from the mouth, then buccal mass, then esophageal pouches, esophagus. Up to this all is a, what, that is a foregut. The midgut, it comprises of the stomach and the, what, that is a intestine. So, the esophagus opens into the cardiac chamber. The cardiac chamber constitutes the main part of the stomach and possesses longitudinal folds on its inner surface, while the pyloric chamber has a transverse folds on its inner surface. The pyloric chamber lies parallel to the esophagus and opens into the intestine. The intestine, that turn backwards and lies as a coil tube. The what? This is the intestine which lies at the what, that is a, the coil tube. Means just after the what, that is a stomach. This is a what, the pyloric stomach. After this, and this is a pyloric cica. And after this, the what next is the what, intestine. And intestine is a what? It is a coil structure. And the intestine is long and forms 2.5 coils. And a short round blind pouch, it is called as a cecum, arises from the pyloric chamber and it opens at the junction of stomach and the intestine. So, here there is a, what, the cecum, which opens at the junction of the, what, that is the stomach and the intestine. Lying on the visceral mass is a digestive gland, and often referred to as a, what, hepatopancreas or liver, which is a dirty brown in color. See, this is the, how is the, what, the digestive gland. This is the, what, the digestive duct, or the, what, that is a digestive gland. And this is a duct of posterior of the posterior, a duct of the posterior digestive gland. And this is a duct of the anterior posterior, anterior digestive gland. And this is a anterior area of the digestive gland, and this is a posterior area of the digestive gland. So, if you observe the structure of these, it has two lobes, one smaller in close contact with the stomach and the other larger extending up to the apex of the spiral. Apex of the spiral, it is apex of the shell or the terminal end of the shell. A large duct comes out of each lobe, and two ducts unite into a common duct before opening into the stomach by a common aperture. The digestive gland, it comprises of the three types of the cells. Which are they? They are secretory cells, resorptive cells, and the lime cells. The digestive gland that possesses secretory cells, they secretes the cellulose digesting enzymes. Resorptive cells, they digest the protein intracellularly, and the lime cell store the calcium phosphate. Then next to intestine, that is a, what, the rectum or the hindgut. The posterior part of intestine is a, what, the hindgut. Means after the intestine, there is a hindgut, and the posterior part of intestine is a straight and it is a thick wall. And it is called as a, what, the rectum. It lies on the floor of the right side of the mantle cavity. And this rectum, it terminates into opening that it is called as anus, and which is situated near the mouth on the right side of the head. The hindgut is ectodermal in origin. So, the, what, the entire digestive system, it comprises of foregut, midgut, and the hindgut. The foregut, it comprises of mouth, then buccal cavity, esophageal pouches, and esophagus. The midgut, it comprises of the cardiac stomach and the pyloric stomach at the junction of the, and the, what, intestine. And at the junction of intestine and the, what, that is the stomach, there is a blind outgrowth, and that is called as a cecum. And after the intestine,
the terminal portion, that is the hind gut, which comprises of the tubular part, and that we called it as a rectum, which and the hind gut is ectodermal in origin. Then next to this, the feeding and digestion pila. Pila is a herbivorous and food consists of aquatic vegetation like Vallisneria and Pistia and algae attached to the rocks. With the help of the jaws, the food such as Vallisneria and the Pistia leaves are cut into smaller pieces and then pushed into the buccal cavity with the help of forward and backward movement of the cladula. On the other hand, while feeding on the algae material, the protractor muscles of the odontophore pull the odontophore forward, causing it to protrude slightly out of the mouth over the substratum. The protractor and retractor muscles of the radula now contract alternately. Thereby, it moves the radula forward and backward over the odontophore. The radula moves against the substratum and the radular teeth scrapes away the algae and other particles on the substratum where that is into the buccal cavity. The contraction of the retractor muscles of the odontophore returns the odontophore to its resting position and thus drawing the scrap food material into the buccal cavity. The food is cut and masticated into the buccal cavity. The salivary glands that pour their secretion into the buccal cavity, where it mixes with the food and the starch is converted into the simple sugar or soluble sugar. The food is digested in the stomach by the secretions of the digestive gland. The digestive juices of this digestive gland bring about the extracellular digestion, while the intracellular digestion takes place in the resorptive cells of the digestive gland. And so in pila, both intracellular as well as the extracellular digestion is there. Cellulose is digested intracellularly in the digestive gland, and the digested food is absorbed in the digested gland and the intestine. The undigested food is voided out or released outside from the body through the opening that we called it as the anus. Into where? Into the branchial chamber, from where it is thrown out of the body with the outgoing water current through the right pseudopodium or right nuchal lobe. So this is how the food and feeding mechanism in the pile. Thank you.